No.
Okay.
I don't know. We'll see. This is kind of weird because you haven't seen the movie yet. I don't know if anyone has any questions about the movie you haven't seen. I will be at Borgner's having a drink afterwards if anyone has any questions.
Afterwards, not during, afterwards. Don't leave.
Yeah, don't leave, please.
So John, which point did you come up? Because obviously you're coming off the back of Winter Bone. You get the script, you know Dennis. Talk about that process in leading into this film.
Sure. Dennis and I have a common friend named David Yao, who used to sing for Jesus in Israel. David, stand up.
Where is it?
I got a script, and through various rewrites, eventually just kind of found my way to it. Took a while.
Long while.
Grew on me, and that was it. So, okay.
Was it a cinema process? Like, at what point did everyone else become attached to the film?
I don't know.
I wrote their parts, because they are my good friends, so I wrote their parts, and they all came in and then saved the day, and it was miraculous, but I did not know her, but I'm glad to know her now.
Are you kidding me? It was one day. It was 4 hours. In my mind, it was two weeks.
It felt pretty intense. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Like I said, he wrote these parts for us. So, you know, for me, it was just a great... I mean, I've known Dennis for a while. We both make short films at the same time. And so we were doing the festival circuit, and we ended up being neighbors. And so there's this one night where power went out across the street from us at the school in Laurel Canyon, and it was like sending sparks up in the sky. And I smoked a little marijuana and decided the aliens were landing. And so my wife and I were like, we gotta get out of the house. We have no cell service. It's Laurel Canyon. We gotta walk down. And I was walking down and I see this cigarette butt glowing. And it was like, hey, are you Ryder? And it was Dennis. And he was sitting on his porch and we became friends and have been friends ever since. But he wrote this part for me and it was just an opportunity to do something that I would never, it's a part that I probably would never even get an audition for, which is always for me the best part. You know, the kind of role that I would never be considered for, but that I know I can do, and Dennis knew I could do it and we had a lot of fun.
So the moral of the story is for inspiring actors, just get really, really high, go walk around and look for aliens.
Exactly. Experience life, meet people, get out there. Yeah.
Dennis, this is a directorial debut, right? And it's pretty audacious, it's kind of crazy. Were there any points where you're just like, this is just too insane? Like, what were the lows and what were the highs? Because it is... I mean, this film is great, right? I'm not building up, don't listen to people. It's incredible, but it's so audacious.
Yeah, and it's also, for you guys, there's much crazier movies playing at this festival than this, so don't expect too much craziness. It's a little crazy, but the movies playing here are wonderfully crazy.
But so, lows and highs of the production.
Yeah, it was just we were trying to do something that most people hadn't attempted to do, and we didn't have any money, and I'm a first-time director, so no one gave a shit what I was trying to do, and it was tough, but there was, you know, we figured it out, and I had great people behind me. And
I think Dennis is a brilliant director, and he was the first time.
I didn't have any problem working with a first-time director. Dennis isn't a first-time director. He's done a few shorts that were both really interesting, I thought. And then I
let's go.
Let's go.
Yeah. Thank you, Dirk.